Hello and welcome back to Dark Souls Remastered. I'm going to rest here before I forget. And yes, we are going to explore the archives a bit on this episode. Oh, you're a fool. Okay. So there are two main rooms in the archives, and there are three floors to each room, and each floor also has, you know, one terrace on each side. So 12 different spots we have to check out, by the way I see it. Now, I would say that two of those spots we explored on the way in. So those wouldn't count, and now we have these two also explored. So I think we've got the lower floor completely explored. That's why I don't like this place. Everything here just hits so hard, and there's a lot of it. I mean, this is one of these situations. You've seen me do this a few times already. I kind of rushed through the enemies, didn't feel like dealing with them all, and now they've all caught up with me. And I've gotta work my way out of this somehow. Got me. There you go. Duke's Archives, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I think this is going to be an episode of frustration. I can feel it already. If I weren't on camera, this is a point where I would just walk away from the game, you know. I said very early on how you can't let yourself get frustrated, or it just keeps getting worse. Yeah. I think it's about to get a lot worse. Stop. Just stop. Leave me alone. Come here. Get off. Okay. Leave me alone. Where are you even coming from? Where did you come from? Yeah, this is an episode of frustration right here. Finally got that Chandler down. Okay, I think I'm gonna go for this, even though I think I might hate myself for it. Well, there went that plan. If I hadn't gotten shot, I was gonna go for it. There's a crossbow down there, it's called the Avalon. It shoots 3 bolts at once. It's a pretty cool weapon. I don't think I can use it with this character. But I was gonna just show how to get it, or how I get it anyway. There's probably an easier way. Actually, I know there's an easier way because there's like a glitch you can do. But it's down on top of that bookshelf in that chest down there. And basically, for me to do it without the glitch, I would spin this, and then if I just walked down as it spun, I was able to time it out so that I dropped off the edge as the bookcase was going over that ledge. And that's how I got it. But there's some sort of a... I don't know if you can really call it a glitch, but if you're down on the terrace closer to that, and you go up the rotating staircase and spin them, and then quit out of the game, what will happen is moving surfaces don't really count for your progress as a character. But your actions towards them do count. So the stairs will still be spun. But it will place you back at the last place you were before you stepped on them. Which would be the terrace that is now just right above. The Avalon. I feel like we haven't gotten the key to save Logan, but I can't remember exactly where it's at. I have an idea where it is. Okay. This is where we came in. So this is the last to inspect. And we got everything.
Cool.
And this is a beautiful, beautiful shortcut. Because if we pull this, it slides this bookcase to the side, and we are right back at the bonfire. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Okay. And we'll open this. Just a blue tidy chunk. Not all that impressive, if I'm being honest. The channeler set. A stinking mimic. Drops an enchanting falchion. There's the giant selkie. That is how you free Logan. If you want to go back into the prison and get him, which I do not want to show. I think he's just going to be stuck. Unfortunately for him. Prism stones. I don't think we've had any of those before. Those you can drop over an edge, and it basically it'll make a sound if the drop is deadly. Pretty cool little thing. I don't know why I'm choosing to come up here and fight these guys. There's legitimately no reason for me to do this. So I'm not going to. I got those. Those guys are all just crowded around in a circle. There's a thing we can pick up, I guess. That boy just one shot. Yeah, I didn't quite expect that from him. Okay, here we go. Let's try this again. Thank you. Gotcha. Oh, hello. Yep, that's cool. Oh, absolutely. All right. So that is Siegmeier's daughter, who is searching for him. And we are entering into the Crystal Caves. Interesting. Interesting hitbox there. Around three crystal lizards. Got two of them actually. I'm actually pretty impressed by that. Here is where you would use these prism stones to mark this path for yourself so that you can get across there safely. I'm gonna try. This is usually a bad idea. You can come in here, you pick up this soul over here, but you get the attention of that stupid butterfly, and he doesn't like you. I mean, as you heard me say, it's a risk. It's a risk to go get that item. If I would have paid a little more attention there, I could have survived that situation. That was a slow-moving attack that was following me. If I had rolled towards the attack instead of away from it, everything would have been great. But I couldn't see it, so I kind of panicked. And there's your result. There's your results. Here we are with a bunch of frightening looking clams. Purging Stone. We bought one of those way back, I think, episode 3. Never had opportunity to use it, which is a blessing, obviously. Come here. This is one of those fights. I never really figured it out. You know, I just do this fight and eventually get lucky. That's how this one works. So I let him come over here. Right before he starts attacking, I bring that up. He will shatter that crystal that I was standing beside. And that crystal is oh, I'm dead. That crystal is actually the secret to his immortality. So, yeah, him destroying it is not the best decision. But what just happened there is what happens to me every time. Every time that I fail this fight, that's what you're going to see. He's going to do his thrash, and I'm not going to be able to get out of the way of it. You know, it's a problem. It's a problem that I've never really gotten a good grasp on this fight. Basically, if I'm too close, he will thrash and kill me. If I'm too far away, I can avoid the thrash, but he'll just turn around and use his breath on me. So, all in all, just not a great situation. And it's a pretty sizable run too, which is unfortunate. I just realized we're kind of getting close to the end here. I mean, DLC is going to take up 4 episodes, so we're not really that close, but if it weren't for the DLC, we'd be right there. Like, we're getting... I mean, I guess going into Izalith is going to end up costing 3 episodes. Unfortunately, that crystal does come back. So you do have to, again, get it destroyed. You can just do it yourself if you want. That's definitely an option. Super unhappy that only one of those hit him. I was almost completely sure the second one hit, and then I watched the third one, and it looked like it was going to be a hit, but obviously it didn't become one. God! I saw it coming that time, and I didn't evade quickly enough. Huh. Yeah, that one. That was unfortunate. I mean, that he very obviously telegraphed that. I just didn't do anything about it. Come on. Come on, come on. Damn it! I mean, what do I do? Please, tell me what I have to do, because I don't get this. Do I bait a front attack, go to the side, get a swing in, and then go back to the front again? Like, it seems like you can't safely stay to his side or his rear, or he'll kill you with a thrash. But if you're in his front, he's just gonna do the breath attack. Like, there doesn't seem to be a way to be safe with this guy. Not that I can find anyway. here we are. I like that damage. I mean, that was nearly a third of his health already gone, but it doesn't matter. I mean, I guess I have to try to stay in front. I don't know what else to do. Not directly in front, but not getting around. Beyond his tentacles. That's what they are. These ones that aren't hitting are super frustrating. So yeah, kind of staying in front's a pretty good plan, apparently. Oh man, I'm just happy it's done, honestly. I don't even feel great after that win. I'm just happy it's done.
Okay.
I think we'll go to Daughter of Chaos next. That seems like a pretty good plan to me. I'm not putting off the Four Kings for any reason. I actually really like the Four Kings fight. As always, thank you guys so very much for watching, and I hope that I see you soon.